Okay, working on a Shorelander boat trailer. Shorelander boat trailers typically use wear sleeves, and the wear sleeve is for the bearing inner seal, which is to from this sits on the hub to ride on the rubber double lip seal. This trailer, the old wear sleeve, the double lip seal would sit in the back of your hub, and then in behind that you have the rear bearing, and the back side of the rear bearing, which would be this side, pushes against the wear sleeve, and forces it onto the hub a bit. Wear sleeves, typically, if you were to look at something like a speedy sleeve, have to be driven on. And what you notice that with a Shorelander wear sleeve, when you put a new one on, it will be on very loose. The difference is, and the problem is, that Shorelander designed their wear sleeve that the inside diameter of this sleeve that's pushed on here right now is 1 inch 732,000. As per their specifications, the outside diameter of the spindle that the wear sleeve sits on is 1 inch 720,000ths of an inch. There is a 12,000ths of an inch difference. 12,000ths of an inch total difference is about 6,000 all the way around because it's a radius. Okay, on the circumference. So anyways, this wear sleeve, I've already popped it off. To get one of these wear sleeves off, a lot of times you can just put a screwdriver. There's a bit of a lip between the black part of the axle and the very back of the wear sleeve, and you can pop it off. If it won't pop off like that, then you would have to heat the sleeve up. The sleeve is put on, as per Shorelander, with red Loctite. You would have to heat the sleeve up to about 500 degrees to get the Loctite to turn to a more of a gel. You're only heating the sleeve, the wear sleeve, you're not heating the whole spindle. And then you should be able to pop it off with the screwdriver, clean up the sleeve underneath, and then you'll be able to put your new wear sleeve on using red Loctite. These are the directions from Shorelander. And if you notice, they're using red Loctite, and they just say to use permanent Loctite or comparable adhesive. Shorelander themselves uses Titan 7262 brand of Loctite. That's equivalent to Loctite's own brand of 262, or in Canada, it's very easy to get. It's hard to get Loctite, but you can get Permatex 262 Loctite. This is 26200, but it is 262 Loctite. You can get this at you can get this at Home Depot, Parts Source, many other stores will have this red Loctite, the 262. Okay, so this is Shorelander's directions from Shorelander, and they're telling you to put the red Loctite on. They only show putting a couple of drops, and then it shows all squeezing out everywhere. Instead of using dropping it and having Loctite going everywhere, I use a paintbrush, just you can get them at the dollar store, pack of five, whatever, artist type brush, and I will paint that on the red Loctite before I put it onto the trailer. The excess that spills out, this does not set right away. This takes forever, and in fact, if it's exposed to air like this, typically it doesn't ever harden. The Loctite works, it's an anaerobic Loctite or anaerobic fluid, which means it needs to have a lack of oxygen in order to harden. So if you put it on a bolt and a nut thread, and as you screw it on, what is underneath in the middle of the bolt, that hardens. The stuff at the edges, typically you can wipe that away. And that's, we're talking a considerable period of time afterwards, it's still not hard. I mean, hours and hours afterwards. So when I paint this on at the back, I'm going to paint it on towards the back side of this area. And I'm going to make sure I cover good width of it. And with their method too of doing this and just putting the drops on the top, as we talked about, there's a 5 or 7 to 6 thousandths gap all the way around. I want to paint it all the way around so that when I push this sleeve on, there's not any space for the water to intrude underneath the wear seal, because the wear seal is riding on the top of this, not underneath of it. It rides on the top. Your rubber bearing seal, it rides on the top, but what's to stop water from coming underneath? So by painting all the way around, hoping to get a better seal and get it to stay on. This old one, this old wear sleeve, I'll pull it off. This old wear sleeve, you can see it has a couple of grooves in it, and that was made by the wear seal, the bearing rear seal that was riding along on top of it. Okay, so this, when you put this on, you'll see it just spins by hand, but the rear bearing pushes against this, right? The back side of the inner bearing on your hub will push against that. And just quickly, I'm going to pull out, this isn't in the hub obviously, but this makes the same thing that usually the rubber seal, the bearing seal, rides up on the shoulder of the wear sleeve, but the actual rear bearing inside of your hub will push against this. If you put force against it, this becomes difficult to turn automatically because it's got pressure, but you don't want to overpressure your bearings. And it's this front part that sits on the race, not the outside. The front part that is not sitting on the race, I'm sorry, this will ride on the race, these piece ride on the race, but that underside sleeve is where you're getting your force from, right? That sleeve that comes to the back because it comes out the back of the bearing. Okay, so once you pop it off, you clean up the edge, you sand it, you get rid of the old stuff that was on here, right? The best you can off of the axle. Then I'm just going to use the artist paintbrush. I'm going to use the Permatex or the Loctite 262. Going to paint a layer all the way around and put it on. Slide it on. I'm going to hold it in place. Give it a good 15 minutes to dry like that. Push the bearing sleeve on. Make sure it's on nice and square and tight. And you got to leave it 24 hours to harden. You can't do this right away. It's a 24 hour for Loctite to cure properly. And then the next day I can put everything back together.